small town, Arevivo, was a very busy town with tiny shops that littered the trees that overlooked the farmland below. The townsfolk lived up in the trees as well, maybe on top of their shops or in one of the tree neighborhoods, a comfy, well-protected hollow in any tree. The sun was bright, and it was showing its lovely face to the world below. Sir Jade and his friend Thomas were flying to their new job. Through the well-organized and complex city, they flew to the Iron Shrine and Co. workshop.
Oh man, I'm so excited for the new invention that your dad is going to add.
Yeah, so it'll be quite interesting, won't it?
I think Mr. Willow said it was going to be faster way to make the shines.
The two approached the big tree that held the workshop. Just as they approached, a voice came over the megaphone.
Attention all Iron Shrine workers, would you please join me in my office? I have very exciting news.
You heard the man, I'll race you.
Thomas entered the tree that held the workshop. A crowd of ravens had already gathered around Mr. Willow and a huge carp that covered something bulky.
What is that?
Not a clue.
Gather my trusted employees. The engineering lab has brought us something very exciting new. I call it Super Shiny Maker, or SSM for short. It has an arm that can press any old block of iron into any shape imaginable. It will make your job so much easier and faster.
Wait, but what about our jobs?
Yes, I do suppose you will be getting in the way of our machine, so I guess we won't be needing you anymore. Let's see. The entire fifth floor, you've been excused.
The fifth floor was the manufacturing floor, the floor where Sir Jade had always wanted to work, the floor where he and his friend worked, or where they used to work. 100 or so ravens gummy walked out of the room where they had entered with a smile on their face and hope in their hearts. Now it was just a shattered dream.
Come on, Jade, there must be something you can do, right?
But I can't do anything, Thomas. The machine isn't ready to go that fast. They were about to take over the business eventually.
Sir Jade has started off the day with a rare opportunity of a new chance to make a difference in the world. Now he left with the feeling that all his hard work and dreams were gone, stolen by the machines. The moral of the story is don't let the machines take over the world, because the more machines there are, the more pollution and less jobs there are.